Every great show needs a good start, and nothing kicks off a rodeo like bareback bronc riding. Unlike saddle bronc, bareback riding didn't derive from the work of a cowboy, but was born purely for sport and spectacle as a rodeo exhibition in the 1910s. Bareback riding was tailored to rodeo's biggest thrill seekers from the start, as riders were originally left with only the horse's mane or a loose rope to hold for security. It wasn't until 1920 that the event adopted leather handholds around the horse's withers, giving the cowboy contestants a firmer grip on a wild ride. Geared with just a single rosin leather glove and a pair of bronc riding spurs, the rider grasps onto a suitcase handle for serious business. After the chute is opened, both rider and bronc are responsible for putting on an 8-second show. Rides are scored on a cumulative total of 50 points each for the performance of the wildly bucking horse and the determined spurring cowboy. Though it gained popularity in arenas throughout the 1930s and 40s thanks to rodeo venues installing side-opening chutes, bareback riding didn't become a standard event in sanctioned rodeos until the 1950s. One of the greatest and most consistent bareback riders of all time was Eddie Akridge. Akridge took home the Rodeo Cowboys Association World Champion bareback rider title in 1953, 54, 55, and 61. Today, Akridge is considered an American rodeo legend. You can learn more about rodeo history in the American West at the National Cowboy and Western Heritage Museum in Oklahoma City, or visit nationalcowboymuseum.org.